Hey guys, it's Jason from Train 2.0 here, and in this video, we're going to break down TJ Oshie's shootout formula. And obviously, this guy's one of the best in the NHL at the shootout, and does he have a formula? You betcha. So let's take a look at it. Just drawn up here, here's what we see that he does. Almost every single time, talking well over 80% of the time, TJ Oshie's going to pick up the puck down the center, because that's where the puck is, cruise out to the right, and then he's going to cruise back into the middle. Then we're going to see one of three things. Everything branches off of this pattern. He's almost always going to take a right crossover, and then he's either going to shoot deep backhand or deep forehand. Now, obviously, I mean, that's kind of obvious. Those are your three options anyway, but this is the pattern that he always uses. So now you've seen the pattern, let's just watch a few of his goals and see how it plays out. So here's the out wide, here's the crossover that almost always happens, and then there's the deep backhand. Next one is the same, and then here is his second variation. This is the out wide, crossover, shot. Now, the last one is here. Where he's going to fake the shot and then fake backhand, go forehand. Now, let's look at this a little bit closer and why it might work so well. The thing that Oshie might be thinking when he's seeing these goalies is, and if we go to the back to this, if the goalie's sitting back, he might be thinking shot, and if the goalie is sitting up, he might be thinking deke. Now the really nice thing is that whether he fakes this shot or actually shoots it, it's always going to feed into the other. What I mean by that is, in this situation here with this crossover, right here, Oshie can shoot it. Or he can go right in very smoothly into the backhand. So it's just this really nice pattern that he runs consistently that allows him to really get that goalie moving, and then also allows him to get that goalie moving laterally, because this crossover, we'll go back, the crossover that he uses here really causes that, you'll see as he crosses, that goalie kind of has to move a bit, and then he's able to read that goalie not being in a good position, and then fake backhand and score. And then, like on Luongo here, it looks like he's reading Luongo being pretty far back in his net, and is able to, instead of doing the fake shot, he's able to cross over right into that shot. And Luongo's thinking, oh, maybe a deke's coming, but he's able to catch him completely by surprise. And then the last one is just kind of a mind game where he's thinking, well, I know he always kind of either shoots or goes backhand, but Oshie goes backhand, forehand. So the nice thing, again, about this pattern that he skates is it gives him a lot of options, and it gives him the right spacing, and it allows him to get the goalie moving forward and backwards, or not forward and backwards, side to side. So just wanted to go over Oshie's shootout formula. And if you're interested in a breakdown of the mechanics he's using in order to pull this formula off, we go over a more in-depth breakdown in the Train 2.0 membership area. So if you're maybe a player or you want to work on mastering this sort of thing, welcome you to check out what the Train 2.0 membership is all about. You can test it out 7 days for free. If not, I'm hoping that you enjoyed this breakdown, got something useful from it, and Best of luck with your hockey viewing or playing, and we'll see you soon.